Hello all across Sim Nation, this is NJP Sims coming at you once again with another Sims 2 video. I've been doing a few of these Sims 2 videos because I'm really happy to be able to play Sims 2 again. It means a lot to me. I'm going to do a little exploring today. We're going to be exploring Deep Gorge, exploring some of the households in here. So let's get on with this, shall we? We'll go in to see what's going on in Deep Gorge as we watch the loading screen. And while we're at it, can we check my volume and see... What? Why does it do that every time I say the word volume? I don't know, but okay. I just won't say the word volume anymore. I won't say that word anymore. So, all right. So how you guys doing? It's been a little while since I've been real active on this channel. I'm going to try to change that and make it happen where I'm going to be more active. So here we are in Deep Gorge. Hello. Yeah, Larry King much? I do that out of total respect. All right, we're going to start off here in Deep Gorge. We're going to be in Lower Deep Gorge here. Check out a few households. And first of all, we're going to look at the... this is a testing house that we do. I really don't do a lot with this family unless we're doing testing. So the Hansen family, we have mom, dad, two kids, and that's it. We'll take a look in and see what these guys are up to. And here we are with the Hansen family here once again. Oh, boy. They're sick with food poisoning. Wow. Well, we came in at a very inopportune time, didn't we? The Hansen family is not doing well. They're sitting around in their skivvies, and I'm not sure exactly why this is. One of the kids decided to go to sleep. let's see, what are their moods looking like here? The energy level is down low, but not too bad. What time of night is it? Oh, it's 3:57 it's 4 o'clock in the morning, and these guys are all just kind of sitting here doing whatever they're doing. I think I should be sending them to bed. What do you guys think? I believe this is the boys' room. We're going to put him to bed. Sleep in your jammies. Pascal is healthy again. Yay! Outstanding. Outstanding. You are going to use the turlet. Clean the turlet. I'm going to send you to bed without a shower. Sleep in your jammies. Pascal is... They're all tired. She needs to be... Blatified too, and they're hungry. She's hungry. All right, just go to sleep. I'm gonna have you wake up, and then we're gonna send you upstairs to your bed, your proper bedroom, that is. And now you can go to sleep in your jammies. All right, Morgan is done in the toilet, and everybody's off to bed. On a Saturday evening at 5 o'clock in the morning. A late night at the Hansen house here, I guess. It's a little look at this family. And nice looking house. I really like this house a lot. And you guys have seen it in some of the tests that we've done before. So, let's jump back out of this, head back to the neighborhood. We'll check out the next place. And I'm going to save this. All right, we're back out in the neighborhood now once again, and just for the fun of it, we'll check out a couple of the empty houses here, too. We'll look at the house that's loosely based on the Goth Mansion from The Sims 1. Let me do this. I always forget to turn on the lots. There we go. Or maybe not. All right, there we are. Now I can go in there and check it out. Like I said, it's loosely based on the Goth house in Sims 1. You can see the resemblance. It's kind of there. Upstairs. Well, it's different from the... It's the same thing, only different. There's three bedrooms in this one. And wide open space over here. I think that's just a roof there. So, do we not have a roof on this place? There we go. Yeah, that's just a little shed-type roof over the kitchen area. It's actually a nice-looking house. I really, I quite like this, actually. So, go back downstairs. Oops, not all the way. I'm just going to go there. And, it's a pretty fancy little place. I think a family could, it's not really little, but a fancy place. There's another bathroom downstairs. Dining room. Real formal-looking dining room. I like the, I like that. I do quite like this. Nice little, maybe I should make a family move in here. What do you guys think? Interesting house. I like it. All right, and we're back out of the neighborhood viewer here once again, and I'm not going to check every single place, you know, every place in the whole place or the whole neighborhood. I'm not going to check out, but we couldn't go through a neighborhood check, neighborhood overview without visiting this family, the Newbies. Yes, of course we have to visit Bob Newby, see what they're up to. Bob, Betty, and Dandolo the cat. Bob and Betty are up. We have money on the money tree. So Bob, harvest some money. There's no money on it. I thought it was lit up. Betty's headed to the kitchen. Where's Dandolo? Just randomly water the tree. Oh, Betty's taking a drink. And Bob is just going to sit down and... Oh, there's Dandolo. Dandolo's... He's not really sleeping. He's just kind of there. That TV is exceptionally loud. I don't know if it's loud for you guys, but it's definitely loud for me. Whoops, I lost all volume completely there. Hey, I said the word and it didn't happen. Did you hear that? I said the word volume and... Oh, jeez. I thought I finally had that fixed, but it didn't work. It did not work out. So, yeah, that's Bobby Newby. Bobby Newby. Bob and Betty Newby. Betty's done drinking stuff and she's making lunch now. All right. What are the moods? They're really not hungry. I don't know why. Well, Betty might be. Betty is, definitely hungry. So... Yeah, quick look at the Newbies. Kukana. And oh no, she burned it! Oh no, Betty, what did you do? Gosh, yeah. Wow, you're not gonna serve that. No. Clean that up, and she grabs another plate. No actions are available. No. What the heck? Betty, stop eating. That's trash. You burned it. Why do I have no actions available? There you go. Clean that up. Get rid of that. Jeez. Gotta get her doing some cooking. Uh-oh. Bob is heading someplace and they just aged up. Dandolo. Dandolo is up. Well, why aren't you eating? You got food right there. He don't like Bob right now. Dandolo's mad at Bob. I don't... Oh, Bob! Bob knew... What did you do, Bob? Oh, yeah. Way to go. Well, I was going to have you give the cat some... No actions available. Bob! Oh, we got the money. We like the money. No actions are... Oh, because I'm on the cat. That's why. All right. Well, he's going to go get it anyway, so yes. I don't know why. I just crack up. Every time I hear him do that Debutile thing, it cracks me up. Yeah, and another $40 into the tank. Clean out the cat's feed bowl and give him some new food. All right. Now, fill it. All right. And now you got to go fix the turlet that you clogged up. Clogged up? Plugged up. Oh, yeah. All right. You should.
So.
And we're going to leave this family just as they are at the moment. And get out of here. We're going to put the roof back on the house because you just never know if it's going to rain. It seems like it always rains in this town. So that's that. Back to the neighborhood we go. Okay, and right across the street from Mr. Bob Newby here, as we jump back to the neighborhood view, we have the Kensington family. This is the Isaac and Eleanor Kensington family, who are actually, we need to get these guys aged up before we go to the main family. Let's take a look in and see what they're up to. Michael has grown into a teenager over the time, and little Trevor is, let's just jump in there and find out. All right, so let's get the walls brought down just a little bit here. There we go. Let's do this. And it is now 12:15 a.m. in the morning. And it is I paused. I'm paused. Well, first of all, take an overlook. Oh, it looks like Trevor's waking up. Oh, no. And, yep, he's waking up, and Isaac is getting up out of bed. So, I'm not really going to do anything with this family because this is part of the Kensington LP, so I'm going to just keep it paused on this. A little overview of what these guys are up to. I am going to play these guys a little bit off camera to get them aged up and get them caught up to the age of the Kensingtons up on the hill. I know we tried doing that, doing the live stream of them, and it just takes too darn long. So we're going to have to age these guys up, and I'll try to capture some of their momentous moments. Momentous moments. Yeah, remember that term. Momentous moments. And see if I can put together an overview of these guys as they age up. So let's head back to the neighborhood now and off to our next foray. The Night Owl Bowling Alley. Remember the Night Owl Bowling Alley? This is where Monica met NJP Sims. That's right. Out of just a random string of events, NJP Sims shows up down here when Monica was here, and they met and actually played a little bowl. Well, you have to watch that video because we had a little fun down here. Night Owl Alleys, we'll take a look at that real quick. And this is it's perpetually paused because it's in build mode because there's no Sims down here right now. And right over here is where the nonsense, mayhem, and shenanigans occurred. And yeah, Monica and NJP met right here at this bowling alley. And again, like I said in the part, I really don't want it to become anything more than a friendship thing. That would be really creepy if the host of the LP got involved romantically with one of the Sims, wouldn't it? I mean, it would be wrong. So Night Owl Bowling Alley, cool place to hang out, and yeah, I like it. All right, having looked at the Night Owl Alleys here in beautiful downtown Deep Gorge, let's go to the Curse Splash Indoor Rec Center. We'll check that place out real quick. It's a really cool place. I like it quite a bit. I just dropped the walls all the way down. There we go. Let's leave them up a little bit. Locker rooms. This has got it all. We have the male and female locker rooms. We have a sauna. Of course, the swimming pool, thus the name Curse Splash. It's kind of a small swimming pool, actually, when you think about it. But it gets the job done. And we have another hot tub over here. This very fancy corner over here for the hot tub. And another one outside. Yes, we have an outdoor area here, even though it's called an indoor recreation center. This is the outdoor bar and grill area. So if you need to make some food, there's your facilities to make it. It's got it all. We got the deck chairs here. We have a pool table, a little arcade. I think there's a bar in here too. Yeah, there's a little bar in the arcade area. I like it. Like I said, I built this 10 years ago, but I still like it. The Curse Splash Indoor Recreation Center in beautiful downtown Deep Gorge. There, you guys were waiting for me to do the radio thing, weren't you? All right, let's jump out of here and head back to the neighborhood once again. All right, and no tour of downtown Deep Gorge would be complete without visiting Midtown Marketplace in beautiful downtown Deep Gorge with all your shopping needs in one location. Oh, sorry. Yeah. Yeah, I know, dead introduction. It just, whatever that was, it just happened, and I'm not sure what it really was. But there it is, the beautiful Midtown Marketplace in Deep I even blew that one to pieces, didn't I? All of your shopping needs in one location, the Midtown Marketplace in beautiful downtown Deep Gorge. There we go. I got it out that time. Pretty good for doing it without a script, isn't it? All right, so we take a look at here. We have the grocery store, very well-stocked grocery store, produce section, another produce section here, frozens, and, of course, the refrigerated aisle back here, and even a magazine rack. We have it all right here at the grocery store, and if you get a little hungry, you don't feel like cooking, stop in the diner. We have a little diner going over here, and, of course, the clothing store. We have to have a clothier. So, yes, definitely all of your shopping needs in one location, the Midtown Marketplace. I didn't do the radio thing that time, but this is a pretty cool place. And continuing our tour of downtown Deep Gorge, or lower Deep Gorge, I should say. We have our twin apartment buildings here, the wagon wheels, we call those, because they look like wagon wheels. Of course, we have the Plaza Palms Dinner Club right across the street from Midtown Marketplace. Kind of a posh place, if you will. It's got the kitchen, of course, a very, very well-equipped kitchen. Of course, we've got the maitre d', or whatever you want to call it, the greeter that seats you at the table. We have a little snack bar going over here. Dinner bar or something, some kind of a bar anyway. And yeah, very well equipped kitchen. I really went all out in this place. With the volume of customers that'll be in the restaurant, you really need to have a kitchen to facilitate that. So that's that. And then we have over here, when you get done eating, you can come over here for a little bit of entertainment with the live jam session here. This is an open jam session here for musicians to come up and have a little fun. Sometimes they get tips, sometimes not so much. A little relaxing lounging area. And if you get tired of that scene, come upstairs. We have the nightclub and dance floor up here with the DJ and kind of a Curse Flash looking theme on the wall here. Almost an aquatic theme. We have an outdoor balcony out here, tables of course, and a bar. You got to have a bar. It's a nightclub. So when the restaurant's closed up and all the stage acts have gone home for the evening, you can come up here and dance the night away for the rest of the night. Up here at the Plaza Palms Supper Club and Dinner Place, or what I don't remember what it's exactly called, but that's that. Rubik's Toy Store, that's an interesting place. Let's jump in there and take a look real quick. All right, here we are at the Rubik's Toy Store. And yeah, it looks like a Rubik's Cube, right down to the sidewalk even. Almost looks like a Q-Bert sidewalk, though. But it's all based on Rubik's Cube. Rubik's Cube. I can't talk today. All right, so go down the stairs. And, of course, downstairs we have magazines, postcards, toy boxes, and little trinkets and doodads and things like that. All kind of cool stuff. And it's kind of surprising. I got a whole lot of stuff fitting into this little area here. And it's kind of an illusion. It looks like I've got everything set at a 45-degree angle, but I don't. What's a 45-degree angle is actually the walls themselves. Everything else is sitting at the usual 90-degree angle with the that The Sims 2 requires you to do. So great optical illusion. I like the way that worked out. Up a floor, we've got more clothing, of course, you know, the kids' clothing and stuff like that. So and the turlets, you know, that's a unisex one. I mean, I just didn't have room to put two separate ones in there, so they had to do that way. Go around the corner and up another flight of stairs. Oh, there's a jewelry display over here, too. So there's that. And it's off to the side over here a little bit. And then we go to the third floor, and the third floor is all about the fun, the kids. It's toy boxes. It's magazines. It's a chess game. It's another magazine rack. You can sit up here and read to your heart's content. And then when you're done reading, go downstairs and buy it so you can take it home and read it again. Something like that. So really happy with the way this place turned out. Rubik's Toy Store in beautiful downtown Deep Gorge. Bring the kids and have some fun. Let's go to the other side of the gorge over here, to the what is known as Upper Deep Gorge. Even though it's at the same level, the reason it's called Upper Deep Gorge is because it starts going up the hill and finally culminating at the world-famous Bob Newby Highway. And we'll get to that in just a little bit. The Higgins family. These guys are mom, dad, the kid, and Maynard the dog. Let's take a look in on these guys and see what they're up to. Hopefully they're... All right. These guys are... they're all in bed. And I think I'm going to pause this. I said, I think I'm going to pause this. There we go. Sometimes it helps hit the right button. Okay. Mom and dad are in bed. And the kid is in bed. J.D. Higgins. All right. It is 12:36. I can't read. 12:36 a.m. in the morning on a Saturday. So, yeah, this is the... Of course, we jumped into the upstairs of the house. And Maynard's around here someplace. So he's probably downstairs sleeping, too. Or maybe he's out wandering around. I don't know. I don't see him. Do you guys? I don't... Maybe he's outside. Yeah, there he is, out in the front yard. There's Maynard. Maynard Higgins. Even the dog has a last name. So just let's put the walls up on this place and let these guys sleep in peace and quiet here as it is nighttime in Deep Gorge. Who can forget this place? The Kensington Suites Hotel. Gosh, I'm talking like an old fart. Wait a minute, I am an old fart. But let's take a quick look around the Kensington Suites Hotel in beautiful Deep Gorge. Deep Gorge, and I don't think I've ever actually really showed this lot off. I think I had an advert up for it at one point, but that was it. Beautiful place, really, really nice place. A very posh hotel. This is a workout room up here. Okay, we got the treadmill and a weight machine sitting there. And, we have a suite. That's why it's called the Kensington Suites, obviously, because there's a suite there. You got mom and dad's bedroom, the kids' room, and even a room just like a central room to gather in. Looks like this is unfinished. I don't see a toilet in the bathroom, so they would be very unhappy with that, or maybe it's just meant to be only a shower. I don't know. But it's been a lot of years since I built this place, so this is one of the suites, and I believe there's a mirror image of it on the other side. Yes, there is. Mirror image on this side, and this is the main hotel office, kind of off by himself there. And there are a couple more rooms back in here. Another suite, if you will. None of the bathrooms have turrets. Oh, yeah, they do have turrets in them. Okay. We have a little couch in here, a little front room for watching television. Definitely maxed out this lot. Let's go downstairs and look at what we have down here. There's actually three floors here, so this is the second floor, and we have a kind of just a little lounging around seating area over here. And, of course, there's a kitchen. Okay. All right, so apparently this is the hotel restaurant is up here. And looks like a little, this is an outdoor balcony area. And how do you get to that? Oh, there it is, right there, the doors. The glass staircase. It's a really neat place. Over on this side, we have, of course, the arcade. You've got to have an arcade and kind of a conversation area here. Oh, there's a magic thing. Oh, there's some kind of a game I think they can play. It's a My Shuno game or something like that. And then a reading area, kind of a little lounging area. Really nice. And of course, we go down one floor and we're at the main level. We, of course, have another hot tub over here and a hot tub over here. So it's two hot tubs. A rather large swimming pool, for a hotel-wise, that is. Two slides, two diving boards, and, of course, the ladders. And the locker rooms for... Okay, so that is the Kensington Suites Hotel in beautiful Deep Gorge. Let's shoot this up the floors here, and we'll jump out of this. Back to the neighborhood we go. We're starting to finally wind things up here a little bit. Long. Let's jump up to the Bob Newby Highway here for once. And I know Sora Burns. I almost called you Sora Roxas again. I don't know why I keep doing that, because it's been years, many years since you've been Sora Roxas. So it's been Sora Burns for many years. So I apologize for that. I just keep messing up your name. But Jesse, you've been waiting for this. There he is in all of his resplendent glory, and I know that he's a little kid in your LP right now, which I'm finding very intriguing, actually. Seeing Jack Wilson grow up is a very interesting thing. So if you guys... it is Saturday at Quad Toothpicks. Well, it was. It was 11:11 a.m. when we actually checked into the house here. This is Jack's house, a very nice house. His money tree is lit up, too. It's very small, conservative house. All a guy really needs. Nothing really fancy. In fact, the couch is very unfancy. I'll get him a different couch one of these years. His energy level's way, way down. At 11 o'clock at night, I suppose it would be. But, it's a single-level house, single-story, nice little patio out the back there, little kitchen, dining room area, and a little skills room, as I like to call it sometimes, game room. I like the word skills room. I don't know. Just kind of like it that way. And a little bit of room here to move around in case he has company over. And he does have company over once in a while. A very certain person comes over and visits to Mr. Jack Wilson sometimes. And we're going to see where she lives very, very shortly. So there it is. Jack Wilson's house in The Sims 2 in Deep Gorge. He seems to be popping up all over the place, doesn't he? But there. Let's put the roof on the house in case it starts raining. Because we can. All right. Back to the neighborhood view we go for one... final look here, and I know this is the one that most of you guys that watch the LPs on my channel have been waiting for, this eagerly waiting, and the waiting is over. There it is, The Kensington House, the main house up on the hill. This is where the whole Kensington LP started, right here, with old Arnold, and now there's a new Arnold. That's that, and yes, how many times have we seen this side of this house, the front of this house? Just something about this says home. It's just, this is home. This is a Kensington's, this is where they live. It's where they started life out in Deep Gorge, anyway. Their legacy goes back way beyond that. But let's go downstairs, let's drop the walls down, and take a look around the house. And this place has grown. As you remember, when we first started off, it was just this one little place here in... man, oh man, this place has really, really grown. All right, so who's all home right now? We have Marcy, we have Raymond, Monica, Pixie, and Arnold. Yes, Arnold Raymond and Raymond Arnold. Raymond Arnold Kensington is the dad now, and Arnold Raymond Kensington is the son, which is complete reversal of what happened when we first started the LP, when Arnold Raymond Kensington was Raymond's dad. And if you're not completely confused by now, I didn't try hard enough. So yeah, the Kensington house has made some massive, massive improvements over the years, and I couldn't be happier with the way things look here. The Kensington family, and this LP is going to continue. Once I get the other Kensingtons, Isaac and Eleanor, caught up with the aging with this family, this LP will continue, because I miss these guys, and I'm sure a lot of you guys do too. This has been a staple on this channel for many, many years, and it's going to continue. The legacy of the Kensingtons will continue, I promise you that. All right, let's get out of here. Let's head back to the neighborhood, and let's wrap up this video. It's Deep Gorge. There are so many places to explore in here, both occupied and unoccupied houses. I could probably make a three-hour video on this and still not cover it all. The stuff that I've built, and you know, you guys have been in on some of it. Canyon's Edge Rec Center, Kitchen's Cravings. One of these days we'll check that out. Just so much in this town, and it's still growing. We got new places going up over here, new apartment buildings going up. Power plants, office building. Deep Gorge is a thriving little community on the grow, and it looks to continue. The legacy of Deep Gorge will continue. Kensington's will continue. This is it's a fun time. I love this neighborhood. You know, like I said, I built this thing from the ground up, from absolutely nothing. Everything in here is from things that I built. So, and I'm bragging again. I know I'm bragging, but I'm kind of proud of the way things work here. So anyway, I'm going to jump out of here. And again, if you made it this far in the video, congratulations. You've made it now to the end. It's time for NJP Sims to sign off. It is almost 1 o'clock in the morning. That's unheard of in my time schedule these days. But I really wanted to get this put together for you guys and get it out there. So, as always... until we talk again, remember, whatever it is in life you do, keep on doing what it is you do.